and cracker. I'm staying here in this hotel with some very lovely people that I've just met at the airport. They put me up for the night in this lovely, lovely hotel. And it's so sweet of them. And here we have... We have Jess. Jess, what's your dad's name?
Terry.
Oh, why isn't that focusing? There's Jess.
Hello.
Hi, Jess.
Terry. My saviour, my saving grace. And Beata. Beata, say something in Polish to my dad.
Dzień dobry. To wszystko, nie wiem co mówić.
Yes, can we choose one? It's okay, I'll choose this one.
Just walking through the park. Love is in the air everywhere.
Krakow used to be the most important place in Poland.
Look at that green grass. This is the Vistula River.
Oh, there's something interesting for you.
Where?
Just stop for a second. Can you see this little area is Mount Kosciuszko?
Oh.
Now, Kosciuszko, he was actually a guy, a Polish guy, who was very famous in Polish history.
Oh,
and
okay.
There's a guy called Strzelecki who went to Australia, and he named Mount Kosciuszko after this guy called Kosciuszko from Poland. Kosciuszko.
Kosciuszko.
Right.
And this river divides...
This is the Vistula River, yeah?
That divides Poland
into two. Yeah.
This river goes all the way up to Warsaw.
Oh. It goes all the way up to the Baltics,
Baltic.
The Baltic Ocean. Baltic
right.
Sea. Oh, Jess, this is the Dragon Den, just below us. Tschüss und Schwarzen Skissens.
The castle, but where all the kings and queens used to reign. They used to live here. Now we're going up to the bell tower. Still going. Still going.
Where you can see that cathedral, to the right, that's the big town square. That's the most important cathedral in Krakow.
It's on here. Yeah.
It doesn't look impressive here, but when we get there,
it is.
It's got its own character.
Sorry if I'm going too fast. Down to the next. Is playing a sword. Apparently, Poland is improving. We now have tourist information people helping the tourists out. No. Well, there's Krakow. It doesn't have it down here. There's Zakopane. There's somewhere. Another wedding. Oh, policeman. Mm. that the church there that you were pointing out to me from?
Yeah, this one, yeah. That's the one. Every dose, every hour, there's a bugler who plays some sound. At midday. Okay. There's another legend about a bugler in the...
Oh,
yeah. That's right. He stops very suddenly because the legend has it that he was shot. He was killed while he was playing the bugle.
Oh, okay.
So to...
Yes.
Yeah, I'm recording.
Hello! Here I am in lovely Krakow. There's Krakow Cathedral behind us. And it's great atmosphere. It's really beautiful. It's so good to not be at work and be on holiday. It's just, I love it. It's so good.
I'll stop, I'm starting to cry myself.
And so, this is Delaney, my first day in Krakow. So I have got a lot of tape. So we may have hours and hours to watch yet to come for another 4 days. So I'll catch you guys later. Bye.
One for you boys. Well, look at that. Surprise, surprise. Another wedding.
Hello.
I hope you're safe.
people are staring at me. I'm about to catch a train to Bielsko Biala, and I tried getting a bit of a sunburn, but not much. I just thought I'd say quick hello, quick goodbye, and we'll see you in Bielsko.
Well, here I am at Krakow train station. Where are the trains? Woohoo! I'm actually in one. Actually have the little cabins. There we go. Hey Beck, check the penguins out. Oh, the rest of the penguins are hiding. Oh, here I are. Come back to Hornhoff. What's big here in Krakow is all these guys wearing army suits. A lot of them wear. Cool, penguins again.
teraz będzie Bielsko już.
People are sitting there. Now, I've got to find my way out of here. I think maybe upstairs, I'm not sure. It's like run over the Oxbow train station.
Last night, I used to say afternoon, walked around, beautiful, beautiful town, but nothing's open on a Sunday, so I'm glad I arrived Sunday, late afternoon, walked around, had a pizza, and then I actually went to the movies and saw Armageddon. Of course, I had to ask, was it subtitled or not, but no, it was great, because I played it in English and Polish subtitles. Fantastic. So I'm going to go now, walk down the streets, and video a few things. So I didn't take my video camera with me this afternoon because my shoulders are killing me. So I'm going to go down now and have a walk around. It's a beautiful day. And I actually happen to be in not a youth hostel, but a tourist hostel. And I've got my own room. So I've got £8 a night. Bargain. Okay, so I will check these all later. Zimba.
Okay, it's a train station down there. And my flat is up in there, around the corner a bit. So I'm gonna walk from there. Yeah. I'm down there for my beautiful hotel in Bielsko-Biała. Look what we have here, Queensland, Australia. Queensland, rainforest wilderness. from all the way out on the other side of the world. Well, that little green patch here, I had pizza there last night. This is the Polish Square. Look familiar, Dad? Yum, yum, yum. I went into another shop and I had lots of cheeses. Oh, they're the only... Yeah, not as big. But being here, I definitely know where I've gotten my taste buds from my father. Because everywhere I go, there's food that we have in our own fridge. And the smell is great. Thank you. just an indication on how cheap things are here in Poland. They are extremely cheap. I've just had a croissant and coffee for like 80p, which is like $1.60. Very cheap. Very peaceful. One thing they do tend to play here in Poland is a lot of English music. So I do have something in common at the moment. Come down from a place to me, and now have a look over there. Ooh, must have flown all the way from Yamba. If only this camera had smell. A few tennis courts in there. And I'll make my way across over there somehow. Okay, I've made it out of the park. You find a lot of people always looking out their windows. Starting and stopping so much because there's so many big vans coming along. Well, he needs to get a license. Oh, it looks like a train's gonna come through. this is the view from my room. On the side, we'll see the room, not much. It's got two beds. Oops. My washing. And that's ordered. What I have noticed is it's got the nice big doona that we have at home in Yamba. And now, Dad, I know where you get your pillows from. They're just like your pillows at home. Nice big fat ones. Just like home. The train station is just over there. Do you think those buildings still exist?
I hope so.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But you don't have the number of the building.
He has a number on the other the other sheet.
Uh huh. No, I don't. You walked through this park.
Oh, did I?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. There's a long street. Ah, number 21.
21. Vazeri. I walked down that street this morning.
Huh?
But, I just...
Komarovice is
the
name,
street.
For the suburbs.
Oh, okay.
But the main street leading to this part of the city is named from this name, Komarovicka. Komarovice, mm-hmm. The name for the suburbs, and Komarovicka, street, the street. It would be really difficult to find this.
No, yes. Oh, Dad wouldn't know where they were now, but he just used to know them. He's never been in touch with them.
Yeah, but who knows, sometimes it's possible. We say that one mountain, that it's difficult to meet for two mountains, but for two people it's sometimes very easy, mm-hmm. from mm-hmm. different parts of the world.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And your father used to live in, what I'm thinking now, these places are in different parts of the city, and
right.
now I have to prepare the route.
Oh, okay.
So this place you visited, Rynek, is the market here.
Yeah. Oh, right. So that was this one up here.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Do you want to go?
Oh, I've been up there.
So
I went through that market
uh-huh.
and
it's
went up
far.
The hill and
yeah.
to the church.
So you don't want to
yes.
go to this?
No.
No.
No, I've done no. Well, I've been up there and I've got it all on video. So.
Here for one.
Yeah, that's
minutes.
No worries.
Yeah.
That's Maria. I'll introduce you to Maria. She's, this is an old map, the old, Polish, that she has obtained because the river, I've actually walked a few places and seen a few places that Dad's already written, and the river, this is Bielsko and this is Biala, and it's divided by the river. Find out more.
She doesn't know, she didn't hear about this street. Okay, let's start. We'll see.
Okay, we'll see.
Yeah.
Say hello. This is Maria, the
hello.
Lady who's taking me around.
Maria.
And this is our car that we're traveling in.
Here you are.
After the high building.
Oh yeah.
There's the school. The school, of course, now belongs to the state, but
mm-hmm.
it was Jewish quarter, the school. The Jewish school, and here was the synagogue. The synagogue. In
oh
this
yes,
area.
The synagogue. Yeah.
The synagogue.
Oh.
German destroyed this synagogue.
Yeah.
Completely. During the time of war.
That's what.
From the time of communism. The communist party was here in this building. The old town, the old city of Bielsko is ahead.
It's here.
The very narrow street up the hill
mm-hmm.
leads to the Rynek market, old
right.
market you visited.
Yeah.
There is the building number 2 you have on your list.
Where?
On this market up.
Oh, okay.
And we can't go with the
can't
car there.
There.
If you want, we can leave the car.
Yeah.
And
we'll have a. Oh, that'd be great.
And from
wow.
this point, it's the beginning of the old city. The remains of old walls around the old city. Church. We are Catholic, but
yeah.
This area also live Protestants, and this area belongs to them. Here is the only monument for Martin Luther.
Oh, that's where it was.
Monument in Poland.
Mm-hmm. And here is the church, the Protestant church. We have four Protestant churches, so it's a lot. It's a
really lot. Oh, okay.
Small city. And two schools. This oh. school was male.
Yeah?
Male school, Protestant school, and female.
Female. Oh, wow, so close together. Cool.
Uh-huh. And this square is called now Martin Luther Square. Right. And we'll go back to okay. the old city. Interesting city, interesting. I don't mean buildings, historical buildings, but history.
History itself, yes, yeah, not just
belonged
the...
to another country, and Biała belongs to another country, and the border between two countries was on the river.
Biała. The river,
yes.
That's it. Biała means white, doesn't it?
Biała means white.
White, what?
White.
Why is that? Just...
From craftsmen who used to work with, I don't know the English word, they made fabrics, they put them white.
Oh, okay.
They had workshops along the river,
mm-hmm.
and they made the fabrics white.
Oh, okay. He's, this is a typical Polish man. Hey, here we go. The numbers on top of the churches.
It's 550 years from the foundation.
Right, because another church has 220 on it.
So it's San Nicolaus Church.
Right. Yeah, I went down the markets there.
Here.
Oh, is it all renovation? Yeah. Oh, wow.
This church is very pure. It used to be very rich, but everything lost. Remembers this icon.
Yeah.
Definitely.
I wonder if I can stick my head through.
Ask this guy. I'm gonna ask this guy maybe it's possible. I could explain.
No, this is probably not what you say. I'll just stick the video camera in. Oh, wow.
It's this place. But to go inside is...
Oh, that's okay.
thinking of the most precious icon for Poles, Polish people. If they are, of course, connected with the church. I'm not personally.
Yeah. Wow. Does that say?
It's dedicated to the priest. Thought to make this this area Polish, because Bielsko was Polish, okay, but most people were German and Jewish. German and Jewish.
Yeah. Number two is up there.
Number two.
Dad, oh. I've already filmed the. I filmed all this here yesterday, not knowing that this was one of the streets.
So this is the main the market in Bielsk. The market in Bielsk is called Rynek.
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 And I bought you something, Dad, here on the left-hand side. I'm not going to tell you what I bought you, but I'm going to show Maria.
Like there.
Oh, so there's no parts.
There was the spring in the center, and the monument, or sign,
but it's in that old book that you have. Read.
It was much more better than now. Live here?
Oh, yeah, I see. Number one. Oh, I'll get a photo.
Number two.
Oh, wow. Hey, Dad, there's your old house.
It doesn't look too nice.
No.
You know why? The archaeologists make I don't know what how to say investigations. They are looking for something, and there is a plan to restore everything. To restore everything.
Right.
But it takes time. Maybe you'll come in 10 years time. Everything will be perfect.
But we don't want it perfect. Okay. I'll...
Work.
A lot of work, yeah.
They have to do something with these people to live here.
Yeah.
And later.
As you said, the gypsies. They're all kind of the same. That's in number three.
And before the Second World War, and also at the time of the war, in this building there was a police station and there was a prison at the back. If you want to see the prison, we can go.
Yeah? Okay. Yeah.
The prison is at the back of the building where the police station was. Here is it, right. And here's the Protestant church.
Yep.
And this area you visited.
Oh, that's right, yeah. Oh, I see where we are now.
This building.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I guess I see the bath.
Yes,
funny. Street narrow.
They're doing digging for gold.
As I told you. And these walls are reconstructed. They are rebuilt in maybe 19th century or earlier. Mm-hmm. But anyway, we know from the books, from history,
right.
That
yep.
in this area was where the real city was.
The real city was.
The 13th or 14th century. And they are looking now for the real parts of these walls.
Is that what they're doing now? Wow. Archaeologists.
Mm-hmm.
Look, German Shepherd. Oh, not as good as Max. A lot of dogs around here.
That's Chris.
That's the Chris.
This building, the school, your father wanted to see.
Right.
Must remember. It's also school now.
Oh, it's still a school?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Secondary school, kind of secondary school for the children who want to study art in the future. So, this is the school and this building, no.
No, just this one. What's the name of this? Oh, here it is. This is where all the penguins hang out. It's the monastery. This is where they all live. Over there,
yes.
That I walked all through yesterday.
Mm-hmm. Right here is the beginning. This square was called Narutowicza. You have Narutowicza Square. On
oh, okay.
The east.
Yeah.
Narutowicz was the first president for in Poland. Ice rink.
Where they go ice skating.
Rink. Yeah. Used to be.
Now they're tennis courts.
Yeah. And here's the bridge over Biała.
That's what I walked over, yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh. Doing all these
the
things I didn't even know.
The city was maybe 200 meters ahead. The old border of
right.
the city. But now it's harder.
Yeah.
And the street.
What was it called?
Vencelisa Street, number 21, where my grandmother used to live. So we'll find
21. How's that? I've I walked all the way there yesterday. And thank you. can only work illegally. Right. The street I came down yesterday and it was...
Here is the factory.
Yeah, what factory is it?
Very old one.
That's...
They produce margarine.
Margarine, butter.
Oil and margarine.
And it smells.
It smells.
Oh, that's what I noticed yesterday.
It existed, before the war.
Oh, wow. There's 52.
Maybe on the right.
That's where I stopped in the park yesterday and sat down and rested after my like 3 hour walk.
The town hall.
Oh, that was,
now
yep.
It's the town hall for the old city, but far.
The memory of Narutowicz doesn't exist anymore. Now at this place we have memory of Mickiewicz. Mickiewicz, a famous Polish writer who lived in 19th century.
And that's what the photo I took of yesterday in that park.
Yeah.
So I've got that photo.
Mm-hmm. And now we go to... Vencelisa Street number 21, and later we'll try to find the place where your father used to live in Kamienica.
Okay.
And later Cygański Las suburbs.
Okay. This is the train line that I stopped at yesterday.
Train.
No train's coming.
Number 15 we have here.
15.
Everything
everything is rebuilt now.
Yeah.
They are digging everywhere. There's no plate on the building, but no. Definitely.
Number 21.
Must be written here, I'll check it.
Great great grandmother used to live.
Yeah, very nice number building.
20. Yeah, until they've come along and
so your grandmother has to be rich.
Yeah,
a rich one.
Walk around.
Interesting.
Yeah, to see this. This is right. Dad, this is where your mother used to live. Well, what's that?
No admittance.
No admittance. Oh. Well, it definitely wouldn't be the look like this. Oh. What a shame.
So you finished school in Australia and before settling down, you wanted to
travel
and
oh yeah, I have. I've lived everywhere.
Go back and
yep.
Settle.
No. Oh, well, I'll
find.
No, I keep going. Oh, I'll try.
Somebody to. Is the street where tramway used to go to Gypsy Forest. And here was the tram stop down there on the crossing. And this street is the street I found here. Kamienica. Kamienica is the name for this area. We lived 1 kilometer up the road to the right from the tram stop.
Mm-hmm.
In a two-story block of flats.
But
1 kilometer up the road. On the right.
On so the right, we'll so yeah, there'll be no. You didn't put a street number. There's number 12. No. Kilometer up the road.
My name is buildings, two-story buildings. I think we'll find it's quite new.
Be able to recognize something in the film.
Mm-hmm. Port Kirra is quite new.
All new.
The blocks and flats from the 70s or 80s. Okay, or you want to go up to?
Yeah, that's right.
I don't think we will find.
Oh no, fan lined gypsy forest.
Now but this road is wide, but two lines, but it was only one line, and this part maybe is occupied by the tram lines. This building here on our left, to the last station, the last stop for trams.
Oh,
it's bakers.
Bakery.
Bakery and restaurant or cafe. The trams were going inside.
Oh,
the
okay.
The last stop for trams. Here is the beginning of the gypsy forest.
Yes. It goes all the way through.
Roots, there are signs with different colors. The signs.
How big is the forest?
The signs are, you see, on.
Oh yeah, I see that color. Yeah, red and white.
How big is it? I try to show you. It's very big.
Oh okay, no, that's right.
To say where is the end, because
it just keeps going
up to the mountains.
Wow.
Are there, and maybe 500 meters from this place, and there is the swimming pool open.
Right, yeah.
Famous restaurant, not now, but before. Czerwony Kapturek means the girl is from the town. The girl with the red
pigtails, red hair.
Bow
in hand.
It's not
ribbon.
Not a cap, not a ribbon, not a hat. The girl was dressed in red, all in red.
Right.
And she had a basket and went to the forest.
Oh, Little Red Riding Hood.
Oh, yes.
Little Red Riding Hood, that's who it is.
The highest one,
right
here. Most characteristic. The cable car.
Is that where you, do you ski?
Up there?
Yeah, I thought that was a ski.
Ski and cable car will take you. A lot of interesting buildings here, private buildings. Dachas, we say dacha.
An open ski jump. Ski jump.
Ski jump?
Yeah.
Is it correct? Ski jump.
A ski jump.
Ski?
Grass jump.
Ski jump. Ski. Ski. Ski jump.
Yeah, like snow skiing.
A slope?
Yep.
Uh-huh. Understand.
That's it. Yep.
Right, and here meets the main road from the city to the cable car. In the winter?
Fresh air.
Fresh air.
Whoa.
Very nice.
Put me to sleep. Oh, move that baby.
The beginning of the route to the mountain called Stefanka. Stefanka. With the refugee on the top. Building, it's now nothing, but
there was a famous restaurant before the war called Emmenhof.
Emmenhof.
A famous restaurant called Emmenhof.
It's now someone's house.
Now you know what the name Dwoni means. Mm. An area for children. For
oh, there's walls. The pool.
It's for children.
Oh. Oh, I'd still have a go.
Yeah. And gypsy forest around.
Oh.
The beautiful slope for ski jumping is inside.
In
and
there.
Also the theater. Open theater.
Open theaters in there.
Mm-hmm. And the view for Bielsk.
Wow. Look at the small barbecue. It's fresh air. No.
Here to the down. The area where soldiers practiced shooting and the main building. Three times happened that cars.
Yeah. Oh, I've crashed into that house. Okay. Yeah, we'll end up in there. Yawa River.
We are going to Leszczyny. Leszczyny. I want to show you the school.
The school. So many schools. Dad's very highly educated man. Yeah. It's true. Wow. Football stadium.
Only,
oh, it is too.
Only in the city.
Here in the cemetery is where the Pope's parents are buried. you know, no, a lot of people don't even know the Pope's Polish. A lot of people don't even know that the Pope is Polish. They don't know, they. It's like, oh yes.
He did a lot to finish the communism here.
Mm-hmm.
You can't even imagine.
We are going round the city now, then go through it.
Komarovice
railway station.
Don't laugh.
This is the main section,
crossing
of
main point of Komarovice. Don't laugh when you see
huge.
The railway station.
Very tiny town. Polizia lighting there, isn't he?
It's a cultural center in Komarovice. You see Dom Ludowy. Dom Ludowy means Dom Ludowy. The place where people come to meet. In the evening.
That's where I should go. Police the railway station in Komarovice. Wow, so old. Dad's probably been there. You never know. We lift up from the rail station.
The road goes up, so we lift up from the rail station, third or fourth house. The landlord's name was Puhawa. You see, nothing here.
Nothing here now.
The wastes are. find the school Strzeleckiego, but
no
idea where it is. Right. Even my grandmother doesn't
know.
The map doesn't say. What would you like to see?
It's the train station again.
It's closed since 2 years.
Good morning. Here I am at the bus station on my way to Krakow. It's been great here. Fantastic actually. And my bus is back again just because my battery's gone. So we will see you in Krakow.
Okay, hello. Back again. I am now in Krakow, back in the hotel I was at the beginning of the trip, and it's a 3 or 4 star hotel. Very nice, got my own TV, phone, everything. Left Bielsko-Biala this morning. It was about 2.5 hours on the bus. Said goodbye, which was really sad because it was just like I was just starting to get to know the locals here and there and wave to them now and then. Beautiful, beautiful country. No one spoke English. I was there for 3 days. I haven't spoken. 3 days. I went to the President Hotel, which is the one and only big 5-star hotel in Bielsko-Biala. And the reception lady there was very nice. She spoke English. She must be my age. And if it wasn't for her, I probably would have had major problems, but just little things. Even finding breakfast in the morning, they don't eat breakfast. They have bigots for breakfast and soup. For a coffee. Coffee is either espresso, or if you want a plain coffee, they put the espresso just in a glass with hot water. Oh, killed me. So I didn't have the coffee, I just had the espresso, and lived on croissant for breakfast. The croissant, which is, oh, it's not too bad, but I missed my cornflakes and toast. They served beer, you know, from 8, 9 o'clock in the morning. Lots of shopping, so many nice shops. I've bought so much. I've got a whole new wardrobe of bras and g-strings and underwear now. I'm very pleased, very extremely cheap, good quality, and it just feels so good to have on. And Krakow today also, I know I bought a new pair of shoes, but they're only equivalent to £10. Very cheap, extremely cheap. I can't express how cheap it was. And what else? Oh, I've written so much down in my book that I can't even talk to the camera because I just go on and on and on and on about it. But what else? It is 8:15 now, and I fly out. Taxi comes and picks me up tomorrow morning at 6:30. Takes me out to the airport, and I fly back into London tomorrow about 10. And I think that's about it. It's been a great trip. I don't know anyone else who's ever gone to a country and they've spoken their English. It's a vibe. I have. I can't believe it. I was there for 3 days. No one speaks English. Didn't even occur to me that in Krakow they do. They do get the hotel and they do a little bit down in the square and that. But a town like Bielsko-Biala. No chance of any English whatsoever. But I got there, I did survive. I saw all the places, Dad, where you were born and where you lived and the churches, and as you've seen before, all of it. So I will say dobre noc, and it's been one of the best trips of my life. It's great, I survived it. I wish I had someone here with me I would have liked someone to do it with me. It has been pretty London. But not to worry. Maybe next time someone will want to come to crack off and Bielsko be able to be with me. So, next time. Okay, Dublin Ox.